Oh, hey Jake, how's work?
You know, work sucks. It's not like the way that they do it in television with the little you got a cool boss and everything, and then you got like a boss who wants to do crap, and you're working at some crappy job yet you're able to make enough money to live off of. That's not how work is. To me, working in an office has not been portrayed correctly until 2018's Aggretsuko. In 2016, Sanrio, the company behind Hello Kitty and other franchises nobody cares about, decided to make a new character, a little cute red panda in her 20s who works in an office as an accountant and enjoys death metal. This is gonna be interesting. Sanrio produced a bunch of shorts and aired them on TBS. Holy crap! That makes more sense. The shorts focused on the struggles of working in an office, but more realistically, you know, it's not fun. You do have your friends, but it's not like they're gonna be the saviors of your entire life as you work in this office building doing crappy office stuff. But who cares about the shorts? Today we are here to talk about the Netflix version of the show, which is pretty much just the shorts, just an entire series. So grab your cans of coffee and obligatory Japanese pastry and let's watch this show known as Aggretsuko. The show mainly follows the same story of the shorts, just now in 15-minute episodes. The series starts off with Retsuko sitting in orientation at her new job.
Oh hey, I'm Retsuko.
Everything seems normal, you know, it seems very basic anime. There's a voiceover of Retsuko. She's running and she's, you know, in slow motion, of course, jumping off of something. And you see the cherry blossom trees and stuff. And she breaks her ankle. And thus we get the opening to the show. A cutesy little Hello Kitty-esque type of opening, accompanied by this loud rock music. Yeah, it's gonna be a theme. Get used to it. The first episode then continues by showing the reality of it.
Work can bite me.
At the start of the show, Retsuko is very ready and happy to begin this new endeavor in her life, this next step. But 5 years later, reality actually sets in. She's waking up, and this jab isn't all that it's cracked up to be. Her boss is a jerk to her.
What?
I'm gonna need some hot tea. That's part of your job, 'cause it's women's work, yeah.
Her co-workers are jerks to her.
There's no time to be tired.
She's got fake friends.
We'll talk later, okay?
She's got flaky friends.
That import shop we talked about. Where are you going to open it up?
Oh, the shop. About that. There's not gonna be a brick and mortar store.
All the flavors, you know, it's everywhere. I mean, at least she has a boyfriend. She's doesn't care about her.
Oh wow. Crazy how cold it got, huh?
I'm fine. Good thing I brought this jacket.
Yeah. Saw that one coming. But thanks to the excellent writing in the show, we do see a different side to these people. The people in our life who are constantly mean, and we end up seeing a different side to them. It's not because they're just mean, it's because this is how it was for a long time.
It's a hell of a lot different from when I was young. Back then, the boss gave you a ration of shit. No one said boo. I can't even dish it out like I took it back in the day, 'cause now it's harassment. The times, they are a-changing. Getting old's a bastard. But that doesn't mean I should be one. I was too hard on you. I know that now, and I'm sorry.
It doesn't excuse their actions, but it gives an answer to why they act the way they do. Fake friends know they're fake and just can't get out of it now.
Tell me, when I talk to Mr. Tone, does it look like I'm kissing butt? What gave you that idea? I'm messing with you. I know I kiss butt.
Who knows what could happen if they stop acting fake around the office? They might lose their job, and I mean, at this point in your life, without a job, you can't live. And to the flaky friends, well, they commend her. I'll just let her explain it.
Check it out. It works because of all the responsible people like you, working your day jobs, paying your taxes on time, and just making sure our economy doesn't tank. Some of us dance through life, and it looks like we're always living the dream. But it's thanks to folks like you that we can hit the snooze button.
Even her boyfriend wasn't just somebody who didn't care about her. He wasn't doing it out of malice or anything. He wasn't treated as the abusive boyfriend archetype or anything. He just wasn't compatible with her.
It's over.
And this seems to be a notable theme to the show. It's like real life. Nobody is just one note. And I think that's what Aggretsuko tries to get across. And they're excellent at doing it. But I think now would be a good time to get into the characters. Starting off with Gretzko's main character, Aggretsuko. Aggretsuko is a shy, timid little red panda. And I gotta say, they couldn't have chosen anything better than a cute little red panda. It's perfect. She kinda reminds me of Judy Hopps. Wait a second, this show kinda reminds me of Zootopia. It only looks like Zootopia, it's not really. As shy and timid as she is around others, when she's by herself, gets to open up and loves to go to karaoke bars and sing death metal, of course. And if you're watching the English dub, I mean, this is actually, like, good stuff. They got a real, like, screamo dude to do the singing for Aggretsuko. It's awesome. But to be honest, this whole death metal thing, when I saw the trailer, I thought this was gonna get real old. Real fast. But instead, they don't use it as just a way to, you know, do a joke or whatever. It's legitimately her hobby. She likes death metal music.
I wonder what Retzko's gonna sing for us. Oh, the possibilities!
Old school hip-hop, maybe?
Or maybe some J-pop?
Nah, I'm really into death metal!
That's just a part of her character. Being able to scream out her frustrations is her way to vent. But karaoke isn't her only means of self-therapy. She also has two friends, Gori and Washimi. Gori and Washimi take the role of a big sister, basically. They are there to listen and help her by giving her life advice. The thing I like about these characters is that they both represent different parts of Aggretsuko. We got Gori, who is shy and timid. She is what Aggretsuko is.
Oh, sorry. I'm Gori over in marketing.
And then you have Washimi. She is confident and assertive. Everything that Aggretsuko wants to be.
That's a lot of money, sir. Now, I know you wouldn't dream of charging this to the company, right?
Maybe.
This is all coming out of your pocket.
Now, seeing these characters in the first episode, you'd think, oh, well, they're only friends after yoga when they go to the karaoke bar. But no, these gals are legitimately friends. I mean, there was the time where Aggretsuko was complaining about her boss to Washimi, and Washimi actually goes to her boss, the CEO, she's the assistant to the CEO, and goes and tells the head about how Aggretsuko's boss, Tan, is mistreating her, and makes that elephant do something.
Listen up. You can't bury your head in the sand. Tone's behavior is having a direct impact on a female employee's mental health. If you do nothing, what's to stop her from going to the internet with all this? But if you want to see this company's name dragged through the mud, then by all means, let the problem sort itself out, sir.
Speaking of Tan, let's get into Tan. He's another great character. He is definitely supposed to be, at least at first, the antagonist to Aggretsuko. He constantly belittles her. He yells at her for no reason. He has her clean his desk, make him tea, pummels her with a bunch of work on top of that, and then once she does human mistake, like maybe putting a number where it shouldn't go or something, he brushes it off as, oh, well, she's just a woman. You know, that's just what women do.
It's cute, ain't it? Incompetent women are such a pain in the ass, but they're better than the competent ones, am I right?
Now, at first glance, this pig man is terrible. Then why is he one of my favorite, if not my favorite, characters in the show? Well, it's all because of tradition. This is the way he was brought up. It's not like he's doing this because he's just like this. This is how things were when he started working at the office. You didn't talk back to your boss. You did whatever you did. You took the crap. And then when you finally got your position and power later on, you were able to dish it out. But times have changed, and this show really depicts change in a very modern way. Much better than the way that like other shows have done it, at least in my opinion. It's cool seeing him grow as a character subtly. Not 100%, because I mean, I'm hoping there's at least a season 2. Subtly he grows. And you even see by the end, by the last episode, he's the only one willing to give it to Retsuko straight, in turn helping Retsuko realize that her relationship was toxic and ending it permanently.
I'm sorry. Everyone's working hard. And I'm just kind of useless.
You know what accounting's all about? Calculating how much is coming in and how much is getting spent. Every last yen. People who half-ass their numbers never do it once. The mistakes pile up, and it hurts the company. Hurts people, too. How long are you gonna keep half-assing your own numbers, huh? If you keep giving out more than you're getting back in return, eventually there ain't gonna be anything left. You get what I'm saying?
I think I do. You know, you're really a good person.
You tell yourself that. I'm just a bastard who's willing to give it to you straight.
Ultimately leading her to be able to rekindle the old relationships that she had before. Bringing us to the final two characters, Finico and Haida. Now these are her two friends from the office, the ones that she's able to talk to openly and relate to. Finico is that type of person who knows everything that goes on in the office and constantly gossips. Also, she has the best laugh ever. And Haida has a crush on Retsuko, and that seems to just be his character. I mean, there's more depth to it, but I mean, there seems to be more to the story, but that's who he is, essentially, in this story.
Well, yeah.
The two work in tandem with each other. I mean, you got Finico and Haida. They're there to just, you know, help Retsuko blow off some steam in the office while occasionally hanging out after work, but as you see later on in the series, that doesn't usually even happen. Not until they do a double date when Retsuko first meets Ritsatsuke. That's what happens. And then Feniko's there and she's like feeding information back to Haida.
Haida! Hey, are you there?
Stop yelling! I can hear you just fine.
What about Retsuko?
Don't get your panties in a bunch. She's just sitting there not saying anything. When I got up to call, she had her face buried in her phone.
Good.
You got lucky, Haida, but it's not gonna last forever. Just tell her you like her already, okay?
It seems like Retsuko is still available, but then obviously she and Ritsatsuke get together. And it leaves Haida devastated, basically, but he doesn't show it. He knows that he should have just made the move before and is willing to face the consequences.
Who's this guy that Retsuko's dating?
What? She's not dating anyone.
I wasn't born yesterday. I see it on her face. You must know something about the dude.
Okay. It's Ritsatsuke in sales. I never saw it coming. My bad.
That's not your fault I waited too long. I want to punch him.
He didn't do like other shows where he'll stop talking to the main character or just be like very distant. He essentially wants Retsuko to be happy. By the end of the season, Haida figures out something that even Retsuko didn't think of when she first started dating. He realizes that...
Truth is, I don't know you. The Retsuko I know is the idealized one in my head.
And he ends up professing his love for her. And hopefully leading into season 2, we can see where this goes. Is he gonna wait before he starts actually dating? Or is he gonna jump right in? Aggretsuko is a very complex and layered show, from start to finish, depicting life through chibi anime animals and having you relate to them by the end of it. At least to me, the message is very clear. Life is full of hurdles, and they just might trip you up today, but tomorrow, you just might land on your feet. Guys, I had a lot of fun with this one. I actually do love Aggretsuko, and I've seen it twice now. It's a really good show. You definitely should see it. I've been Jay Creates. Live long and prosper, and adios. I'm okay.